This video is brought to you by Saraswati Vidyalaya Union. And hi, this is Prapti. Today we are going to study about biodiversity, conservation and environmental issue. Now let's study in detail about this. Now let's study the next chapter, that is biodiversity, conservation and environmental issues. In this, the first thing that is about the diversity. Diversity means what? Diversity is variety. The variety of life, it is called as the biodiversity. This biodiversity includes a vast array of species of microorganisms, viruses, algae, fungi, plants and animals occurring on earth, either in terrestrial or the aquatic habitat, and the ecological complexes of which they are part. The diversity is with respect to size, means from microscopic to macroscopic, shape, color, form, mode of nutrition, type of habitat, reproduction, motility, duration of life, cycle and span, etc. On this it is totally dependent. Now here, this is actually due to attempt of living beings to accommodate with different environmental conditions, like climatic, edaphic, topographical, geographical, etc. or the situation. This living organism adapt themselves to overcome different situations and thus develop distinct different features, and that has actually led to the diversity in them. The diversity in features become infused in the life cycle. In short, this adaptation in different environments serves as basis for diversity. Now, what is the exact definition of diversity? Now, let's study. So, it is the part of nature which includes the differences in genes among the individual of species. The variety and richness of all plants and animal species at different scales in a space, local regions, country and the world. And the types of ecosystem, both terrestrial and aquatic, within a defined area. It is known as the biodiversity. Now, this biodiversity concept, which is discovered by the scientist Walter Rosen in 1982. But this term was popularized by the sociologist, that is Edward Wilson, to describe combined diversity at all the levels of biological organization. Now, this biodiversity that we see today, it is outcome of over 3.5 billion of years of evolutionary history, mainly influenced by natural processes and of led by influence of humans. Now in this chapter, so we shall study the basic concept of biodiversity, such as levels and patterns of biodiversity, expanses, importance, loss and conservation methods and efforts undertaken. Now let's study about the level of biodiversity. Diversity of living world can be observed at various levels, ranging from molecular to ecosystem level. Now this major hierarchical and terrestrial and interrelated levels are genetic diversity, species diversity, that means it is known as the community, and ecosystem diversity, that means it is known as the ecological. Now, this is levels of diversity. Now, the next thing here, that is genetic diversity. So, the genetic diversity, it is the intraspecific diversity, means in between the two different species. It is the diversity in the number and types of genes as well as chromosome present in different species, means the two organisms having different genes. That's why it is known as the genetic diversity. And also variation within a population and diversity within population that are associated with adaptation to local condition. This genetic variation, that means allelic genes, lead to individual differences within species. Such variation pave way to evolution. Here, they also improve chances of continuation of species in the changing environmental condition, as well as it allows the best adapted to survive. Existence of subspecies, races are the example of genetic diversity. Now here, greater the diversity, better would be the substances of a species. Now see that 1,000 species of mangoes and 50,000 varieties of rice or wheat in India nowadays. Another case of genetic diversity is what? Medicinal plants, that is Rowulfia vomitoria, which secretes active component that is known as the resperpine. So it is found in different Himalayan ranges. This plant shows variation in terms of potency and concentration of active chemicals from location to location. Means in all the plants, the same components are not present. So this plant shows variation in terms of potency and shows variation in terms of concentration of active chemicals. Means the genetic diversity or the variability is essential for healthy breeding population of species. So this was related to the genetic diversity. Means there is the differences between the genes. Now, species diversity. It is the interspecific diversity. Means the number of species of plants and animals that are present in a region constituent its species diversity. Some areas or regions are richer in species than in other regions. Species diversity deals with variety of species, that is species richness, as well as number of individuals of different species, that is known as the species evenness. Here one of the example is given, that is amphibian species diversity. It is more in Western Ghat than in the Eastern Ghat. That's why it is known as the species diversity. Now here, the natural undisturbed tropical forest have much greater species richness than the monoculture plantation of timber plants developed by forest plantation. India is one among 15 nations that are rich in species diversity. Now, the last one, that is ecological diversity. This ecological diversity, it is related to different types of ecosystem, or you can say that is habitat, within a given geographical area. There are a large variety of ecosystem on earth having their own complement of distinctive interlinked species that are based on the differences in the habitat. It can be described for specific geographical regions. Generally, there may be one or more different types of ecosystem in a region. Thus, ecosystem diversity is very high in India, while it is low in Norway. In India, we can find a great variety of ecosystem. For example, desert, rain, forest, deciduous forest, estuaries, wasteland, wetlands, grasslands, etc. You can see the Western Ghat show great ecosystem diversity, while regions like Ladakh and Run of Kutch do not show variance like we observe in Western Ghat. Means the diversity of life at all their levels is now rapidly being modified by modern man. Now, patterns of biodiversity. There are two patterns, for example, latitudinal and altitudinal gradient and species-specific relationship. Now here, the first one, latitudinal and altitudinal gradient. In this, biodiversity bearing arid or sub-arid and aquatic habitat show latitudinal and altitudinal gradient. Means what is exactly this? Now we'll see about first, that is latitudinal. Latitudinal means what? This ecological studies have revealed that the distribution of diversity is not uniform around the globe. Species richness exhibit latitudinal gradient for many plants and animals. It has been observed that species richness is high at lower at latitudes and there is steady decline towards the poles. Factors like overall stability of tropical regions for millions of years, lesser climatic changes throughout the year, and availability of plenty of sunlight that favors speciation. Tropical areas have less often experienced drastic disturbance like periodic glaciation observed at poles. Such a stability over millions of years might have favored speciation. Laser migration in tropics might have reduced gene flow between geographical isolated regions and favored speciation. Scientists also have considered availability of more intense sunlight, warmer temperature, and higher rainfall in tropics as factors are responsible for bountiful of these regions. In more or less constant climatic condition and abundance of resources, some animals enjoy food preferences. For example, fruit being available throughout the year in rainforest, variety of frugivorous organism is obviously more as compared to the temperate regions. But in short, species richness or diversity for plants and animal decreases as we move away from equator to poles. Means what? It is maximum in tropical rainforest, that is Amazon rainforest. Means in that Amazon rainforest, if you observe, so there is presence of 40,000 plants, 130 birds, 427 mammals, 3,000 species. So that is about the latitudinal gradient. And now altitudinal gradient. It speaks for height from mean sea level, that is known as the MSL. That means height from mean sea level upwards. This species diversity is more at lower altitudes than at the higher altitudes. It is because at higher altitudes, change in climatic condition and drastic seasonal variations lead to the decrease in species diversity. So this is about the altitudinal gradients. Species area relationship. Scientists have tried to establish relationship between the species diversity and the size of the habitat. It is considered that the number of species is directly proportional to the area. It is understood that larger areas may have more resources that can be distributed amongst the inhabitant species. Does this always hold true? So, the German naturalist Alexander von Humboldt observed that species richness does increase with the increase in area, but up to a limit. If you observe the graph for species area relationship, you will understand that for many species, this curve is a rectangular hyperbola. If we consider S to be a species richness and A as considered as an area under study, C as the y-intercept and Z as the slope of the line. This relationship can be described by the equation, that is log S is equal to log C plus Z log A. Means on logarithmic scale, this relationship is a straight line as observed in the figure above. For smaller areas, value of Z ranges between 0.1 to 0.2, regardless of species or region under study. But for the larger areas like entire continent, slope are closer to vertical axis, that is steeper. This observation indicates that in very large areas, number of species found increase faster than the area explored. Like this, in the chapter we have seen about the definition of biodiversity. Who discovered the term biodiversity? levels of biodiversity in that genetic diversity, species diversity, ecological diversity. And the next one, that is patterns of biodiversity, that is latitudinal and altitudinal gradient. And then the next one, species area relationship. Thanks for watching this video. Please like and comment on this video. Please share my channel and please subscribe my channel. My channel name is Prapti Vansare. Thank you.